This is a daily Zohar dedicated to Ilui Nishmat Rina Chaya Batzara, Dora Bajoya, Avraham Ben Mazal Tov, and to the Hatzlacha of Parnasa of Fegel Sara Bat Reuven Leib. Okay. We're going to talk a little bit today about a controversial topic that I usually don't talk about. It's reincarnations of the soul. And we'll try to see exactly what it is to try to blow some of the mystery and the cloud of unknownness, and people don't know what's going on in it, and a lot of confusion, a lot of misinformation. And it says the following: the neshamot, the souls, are a spiritual power that comes from HaKadosh Baruch Hu himself, that dress or fit the body of the human, of the person. And since we talking about a spiritual power, like any other spiritual power, or like anything, is a tolada, is a derivative of a combination of two different powers, spiritual powers that are superior to them. One to the other comes another one. The neshamot are a tolada, a derivative of, according to Kabbalah, zivug ha-partzufim, those what they call in Olam Kabbalah, different concept, without getting into it right now, of what is the difference between partzuf and so on and so forth. Zivug ha-partzufim of Ze'er Ampin ve-Nukba, they come in Zachar ve-Nekeva, they're coming together in the world of Atzilut. In Kabbalah, there are four different worlds. Atzilut, where the light is being shattered. Atzilut, not noble. Atzilut mishum leha atzil, mishum tzel, of the Kadosh Baruch Hu into this world, like a filter. After Atzilut, we have Bria, creation. That's all where things are created. After Bria, we have Yetzirah, which is the world of formation. And then we have, finally, where it comes down to this world, it's Olam Asiyah, the world of action. That's why we, in this world, it is impossible for us to create things. We can't create. I mean, I could take something and make something of it, but there will be forming, there will not be creation. And we'll see exactly what is creation. He's making something out of nothing, and that is not something that any human being or any entity in this world could. The only one who could is God. God creates, man forms and shapes through action. That's why you cannot shape things if you don't do an action. If you want to change something, you have to act upon it. You can't wait for things to change if you choose to do nothing about it. And it says, generally speaking, we can say that all the souls were included in Adam HaRishon, the first man, Adam HaRishon, when he was created, when? On Erev Shabbat. But since Adam and Chava were not created at that point, Ela mibchinat achor be'achor, they were back to back, that's how they were created. Nechshav she'abriya ita chasera. The Briah was considered to be incomplete. It was missing. And that's why we need to fix it. It was missing. It wasn't complete, not because of lack of ability, chas v'shalom of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but rather in order to give us humans a chance to be parts in creation. But it was created back to back. Adam v'chava were united in the back, through the back, back to back. Pirusha Inyan, Adam and Chava were the symbol of those partsufim, Zachar and Nukba, right? Male and female together. So when we say that Adam and Chava at that time was Achor be'Achor, back to back, in other words, it means that the Zivug, that unification, was not complete. Until Adam and Chava were able to be separate and then to unite face to face, then it was, until that point, the creation, the Briah, was going to be missing. Until then, it was complete. Therefore, the neshamot that at that time were included in Adam HaRishon were considered to be what we call old souls, old neshamot. Not like most people think. When you refer to people, you said neshama yeshana, old soul, they most of the time refer to as a recycled soul that came down. We're not into the recycling business. We are into, you know what this is? This is this. One shot, one kill. One time you came here, you gotta do it what you can, the best time, the best way. There's only one shot. But neshama yeshana means a neshama, a soul that was created before the separation of face to face, during the separation of back to back. These are the neshamot that need to complete. These are the neshamot that need to do more. So this word is an old neshama. And the mistake that people make in that is crucial. And they take this whole concept and they turn it into something that is completely foreign. So now, and when we are talking about neshamot chadashot, that the zivug, the unification, was face to face, this is what we're talking about, a new soul. So therefore we are talking about that neshama yeshana, and old neshama is a neshama that was included in Adam HaRishon, like that, neshama yeshana, back to back, new one, face to face. And after the ptira, after Adam HaRishon died, chazru v'nitgalgelu v'chasher neshama kazot mitgalgelet, when this nada became available. After Adam HaRishon died, it became available. So when a person receives this kind of a neshama, right, he considered to be receiving an old neshama. And this neshama is being given to you upon unification of the combination of both forces, physical forces of your parents, which is your father and your mother. This is the harmony of the world, male, female, male, female. Only through the combination of these two completing unities, entities, they coming together, then we have the formation of a body. You cannot create a body without two elements to it. So you're going to come and say, well, hello, Rabbi, we could... How do you call this morphing? We could cloning. You're right. You didn't do anything because I want you to make me a cell out of nothing. That cell that you're cloning is also a derivative of a soul. You can't create. You can only reshape. So even cloning is not creation. So all those neshamot that came later on from the zivug of the female entity with the male entity spiritually, these are a new neshama that comes to this world, and that's what it is. Now, how can a person add on to his neshama? What could you do to add on to your neshama? So when a person only deals in asiyata mitzvot bilvat, only doing the mitzvot alone, he rewards, he gets what is so called le'or ha'nefesh ha'nikret asiyah v'lo yoter. In his, again, I hate to use this analogy, but there is a part of his spiritual entity, which is the soul, it has three parts, nefesh, ruach, or neshama. That part of the neshama is being polished, is being shining, so therefore it shines. So when he's only doing action, asiyat mitzvot, he's doing mitzvot. So that is the nefesh, a part of the neshama, it's called asiyah, it's being revealed. Imishtadel, if he tried very hard, gam la'asok betorah lishma, I'm learning, I'm coming now to learn. Why I'm learning? Because I need to learn. That's torah lishma, for no reason, I'm doing it because I need to. Zoche gam lebchinat ruach, that part of his soul that was covered, that's called Ruach, which is the higher one, is being revealed also. We remove that shell from around it, and now both his nefesh and Ruach is revealed, and that already is an accomplishment. If you take for a second, remember those classes that we did for, what was it, like a few years, on the progress that a person has to do when we were learning Mesilot Yesharim, Path for the Just. This is exactly what it is. There's a certain point that if you reach, it's already a great thing. Most people never reach in their lives. So this level is an equivalent of that. Most people barely have the nefesh revealed. Now the ruach is already a tremendous thing. Vegam v'im zachan, if you were married, la'asok bechokhmah ne'elemet, besodot haTorah, and if you merit it, to be able through your hard work, not through your curiosity, because curiosity kills a cat. And a cat got to be a cool cat. And in order to be cool, you got to learn how to be cool. Cruel to be kind, but cool to learn. If you merited, because of your effort and your intellect, to learn the sodot, the secrets of the Torah, zoche gam leneshama. All of a sudden, your three-part soul is completely revealed and now it's shining. So when a person has bechinat nefesh bevad, when he has only that nefesh, megi alav hashefa, the abundance comes from the word, from the name of Hashem, which is Shema Adnut, Aleph Daled, Nun, and Yud, only. Im zacha, if you got the hashpa'a of the Ruach, I mean, if you got to reveal the Ruach also in its shining, you get your hashpa'a, you get your abundance from the name of Havaya, the Yud Kei Vav Kei. V'im zacha l'neshama, and if you're rewarded to have your part, your segment of your soul, neshama to be lit, you are merited with the abundance from the Shem Ehyeh. When you take all those three names together, which is Adonut, Havaya, and Ehyeh, you get the gematria of Yud, Bet, Kuf, 112. Keminyan Yavok. Ma'avar Yavok is the passage of the Yarden. There's a special book about that. But Ma'avar Yavok, why is it called Ma'avar Yavok? Because then it says, V'az yomar alav, Hashem Hoshia, HaMelech Ya'anenu b'yom kor'enu. Lo kar'enu. Kar'enu is kara otanu chas b'shalom. Kor'enu calls upon us. People make a mistake. Kar'enu. Lo kar'enu. And then Yavak, Yud Bet Kuf, Rashi Tevot, Ya'anenu b'yom kor'enu. So now, Ma'avar Yavok is the passage when HaKadosh Baruch Hu called us and the day we call Him. Think about it. Ve'az yeh adam shalem min ha'nefesh, min ha'asiya, ruach ve'yetzira, ve'neshama min ha'briya. So when you reach this level, your nefesh is going to be complete from the, let's call it the filter of asiya, and the ruach, which will come from yetzira, formation, and the neshama, which will come from the level of bria, ve'az yetaken atzmo yoter, and then you fix yourself more, as you lo shloshtan min hayetzira, when you fix yourself more. In other words, you need all these three parts to revealed first. After all them reveal first, only then you, upon working harder, in other words, action, always action, you're able to elevate all of them to the level of Yetzirah. V'im yetaken atzmo yoter, and if you work on yourself even further, yelo shloshta min ha'briya, from creation. V'im yetaken atzmo yoter, yekabel kol ha'shefa me'olam ha'atzilut. Then you're going to get all the abundance from the world of Atzilut. Rabotai, if you ever needed to know, why am I so much against tranquilizers, so on and so forth? You know, why it does not make sense? People talk such nonsense, the Chachamim were doing drugs, it's shtuyot. You need to have such a clarity of the mind and such situational awareness of knowing exactly what is happening, what exactly you're doing in all given time. You can, see, it agrees with me. You can be sedated. You have to have the clarity, because it cannot be done when you are off. If you think that you're going to get what they call a labor dick, you become happy, you know, and you find Hashem closer by having a little, you know, the bitter drink, you know, a little drinking, a little tipsy, you're wrong. Or a little Bob Marley style, you're wrong. You gotta have the clarity of a super ninja Delta Force, of an F-15 pilot. You have to be sharp, knowing exactly what's happening around you all the time. Because everything is happening around you at the same time. Things are coming up your way, and you need to be able to know to take everything and to elevate it. This is happening here, not to have a collision. I call it a cosmic collision. You need to know exactly what is happening, to divert. You need to be aware. The awareness is great, because you can't work on yourself unless you're aware. You want to be spiritually in touch, be clear in your mind. And clarity of the mind also works from learning. And that's why I'm so sometimes hard on you guys when I said to you, no, this is not it. Don't divert, don't divert, don't divert. Clear, 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 clear. Later on, we can sit down over a cup of coffee and we can talk about other things, option this and that. But right now, when we're learning, let's have the focus on what is the reason. As we did today, for example, when we learned the Gemara about the Eichal and Mikdash and the Eruvim, this whole concept. That's exactly what it is. You need to have a clarity of the mind, precision. Therefore, Nimtza, She'adam She'paga B'Nishmato, a person that harmed his soul in B'chinat HaNefesh, when you affect this time, this, you need to fix it. V'zeoto adam yakpid, and all of a sudden you find yourself having a tendency to do this, to do that. With pagam, you did it, not somebody before. When somebody, I have a hard time relating to what my grandparents did. I could relate to something if there was such a reincarnation, my soul came, what have to do with me? But rather what I did through my action. That's why when I do tshuva, I need to do tshuva for myself, not for somebody else did 5,000 years away from me. So if I find something that I want to do, I have an excitement for something, apparently somewhere along the line, I blemish that. So if a person, for example, now has an eagerness to learn all the time, means that somewhere along the life, along the line in his life, he did something that now he needs to fix. HaKadosh Baruch Hu helps you. And that's what we need to do. So that's exactly what happens in terms of Gilgulim. Now, that the Gilgul means how the Neshama rolls to this world, whether it's an old soul or new soul, and what do you do with it now? Now, there is a concept in Kabbalah that, again, people are mistaken with that. It's called ibul. Ibul means, in pure translation, means impregnation. When a person clarifies a soul and elevates himself spiritually higher and higher, many times while he is alive, he gets an extra soul of a sage or a tzaddik that comes to him while he was alive. There is a sefer of the Ramak, it's called Sefer Girushin. It doesn't talk about divorcing, but it talks about divorcing yourself when they used to go to the field, those big Kabbalists, they didn't sit in places like that. They used to go with the mentor, with the Rav, and they used to sit, and they knew exactly through the spiritual energy that come from a particular place that this person, this tzaddik, this tana, this emora is buried here, and they would learn, hopefully, for example, they would go to, let's say, the grave of, Abaye, and they would learn on his site words that he learned in order to be able to receive that hashpa'ah of the soul on him to be able to elevate yourself higher. Now, and that nefesh, and that particular tzaddik, becomes ruach by this person. It comes and it elevates you up. And sometimes, it could be even a neshama of early people, even of like Avraham Avinu, or David HaMelech, and so on and so forth. And it's amazing that sometimes you will go and you would think of something that is your own. Recently, it happened to me that since I remember myself, said things to people, give people a certain advice, and I said, that's my own thing. Guess what? Surprise. It wasn't my own. It's the same thing it said in Sefer Hasidim. So you could be upset, or you could be happy. You could be upset, nothing is mine. Or you could be happy. Baruch Hashem, I was thinking right, you know, to think like Sefer Hasidim is not so bad. You know, I'll take it in any given day. So therefore, that's called an impregnation. So a person, and therefore you'll be able to draw those neshamot down as an addition to you, to elevate yourself spiritually further, it all depends on your urge and your willingness to clean your soul down. And that, again, needs not only an initiating thought, but also an action. So you can have this portion of that soul, of this great soul, coming down, because you connect, again, depends on your ability to clean yourself up to that. And that's what Chazal says. There's no generation that it doesn't have among himself people like Abraham, like Yitzchak, like Yaakov, like Moshe, like Shmuel. In every generation, there are people who, through that willingness and eagerness to work and to clean themselves up, get a part of the neshama of Abraham Avinu. And all of a sudden, he does things, and every generation has it. And that kind of sits along, if you remember what I told you last night about Mashiach and so on and so forth. So therefore, that's what we call what people refer to as Gilgul, happens while you are alive and you get a neshama of a tzaddik. Now, if you remember what we talk about anger, when a person gets very angry to the point that he loses himself out, when the pure neshama cannot sit in this body anymore, leaves it open, and you don't know what neshama, you can get Bil'am, I don't know, inside of you. And you say, wow, my goodness, what happened to me here? So this is how the neshamot come down. So this is how we refer to what is called Gilgul Neshamot. How do you roll the neshamot from up there here? That's why it's very important at the time of intimacy between husband and wife to be at utmost purity. With all due respect to Victoria's Secret and Company, we have nothing to do with that. It's lo shayach lanu. Because for us, this act of husband and wife together is a first and utmost and should be only a spiritual act. And we forget and we miss an opportunity to bring down to this world a pure neshama. But when we don't able to bring down a pure neshama, it's like a lost game before it even started. And then the work is very hard to try to clean this neshama. We are not fair to our children who weren't even born yet. That's why they say, Chazal tells us, the education of your child starts before he was born. It starts with you. If you came to the rabbi upon the birth of your child in a question of how should I educate my son, and you are about 25 years old, the rabbi would answer you, you're 25 years too late. So if you want to give a good chance to your kid, and you want to have it better for him, sanctify yourself, educate yourself, purify your soul, and at the most intimate part of your life, with your wife, be pure. Think pure, because that's exactly when the Yetzer Hara gets you, because you put your guards down. Don't forget, Levush Malchut, the Levush that we put, is not just garments to our body, it also garments of our soul. So as much as you bother to buy yourself clean clothing and expensive clothing, be very careful to do the same thing to your neshama. Slowly, slowly, you clean your soul, segment after segment. Don't stop until you reach such a high level that you're going to get a neshama, an additional neshama that's going to give you a boost in spirituality. That is Gilgul Neshamot. Gilgul Neshamot is how we roll the dice down here. not how we roll on to an endless path of helpless acts of basically it's an impossible act. Gilgul Nishamot is done here and it's done right now. How are we going to roll the Neshama from up there down here in order to purify our soul segment after segment in order to have our children pure, our houses pure, this world pure. And Be'ezrat Hashem and Bizchut Zeh Nireh Biviyat Mashiach Sitkenu Bimera. Amen. Ken Yehi Ratzon.
Amen.